I believe that now at the university we can add some real value, not only to skills development, but also for research and innovation activities in support of the companies. And I know a lot of the companies of interest are here today. But we're also here to celebrate some of the students and the performance of the students on the programme, and I believe that this evening we will be handing out some prizes to high performing students on some of the minerals courses. So without further ado, I'd like to pass you over to Mark, and Mark's going to give you a short presentation on the Centre for Minerals Products. But I do hope to catch up with a number of you later, and I think this is going to be a recurring theme this evening. I can see that the drink's flowing at the bar, so hope to see a number of you a bit later on. Thank you.
Good afternoon or good evening, ladies and gentlemen. What a challenge first. I know I was going to be up against it when I came on the stage today, but up against it with free beer and quarry men, well, to be honest with you, I think I'm going to struggle to hold your attention, but I'll certainly do my best. First of all, thanks again to the Institute of Quarrying for giving us a slot and giving us some time to basically update you on some of the changes to the Mineral Products Centre. First of all then, in case there's anybody in the room who didn't know, this is our home, the Mineral Products Centre home, the Enterprise Centre at the University of Derby. I know what some of you might be thinking, that certainly doesn't look like any university that I've been to before. And you'd be right, the Enterprise Centre is a fully blown business centre for business clients, and that's quite important. The core team then. I'm sure some of you in the room know me. No doubt some of you in the room will be aware of Tony Stock, our asphalt and programmes leader, and perhaps even Peter Revel, who runs our higher apprenticeship programme. Yes, you did hear me correctly, our higher apprenticeship programme. Unfortunately, I didn't get the microphone earlier on when the panel was up on the stage, but when I do get to the higher apprenticeship, I've got one or two things to say with regards to our industry and demographic challenges. But without further ado, one of my main purposes today is to introduce you to the new members of the team. We've worked really, really hard over the summer break trying to improve the Mineral Products Centre and bring people forward who can really add value to our industry and help us meet some of the challenges that face it. So first of all then, I'd like to introduce you to Dr. Andrew Smith. Andy is an industrial minerals geologist by training. He's worked in the construction materials sector his entire career. He started as a staff member at Leicester University, teaching on the industrial, mineral and applied geology programmes. He holds an MSc in industrial mineralogy and a PhD in concrete technology. After 9 years, Andy joined Hansen's Brick European Division as head of research and technical development, working with clay quarrying activities and materials assessment programmes, as well as managing the laboratories. Anybody from the brick industry in the room will certainly know Andy, because for the last 13 years, he's been the principal consultant at Ceram, which is now rebranded as Lucidian, looking after, in particular, sustainability, resource efficiency, secondary and alternative raw materials, as well as a number of other things. Andy's new role sees him as the academic lead for all of the centre's clay, concrete and cement programmes. In addition, Andy will lecture in a wide variety of areas throughout the centre's programmes, and he also brings an excellent track record that will allow him to contribute and really add value to our centre. Andy joined us on the 28th of September, and I'm glad to report he's still with us. So that's a good bonus. Okay, next then. Chris Rowan. So Chris has wide, varied and in-depth experience, particularly on the international front, is certainly impressive. 35 years international and multicultural experience, which can only add value, particularly in terms of our growth on the international market. To give you a little bit of information about Chris, until recently, Chris was the Quarries Asphalt and Concrete Manager at Dantata and Sewu Construction in Nigeria. Chris has also undertaken similar roles in Zimbabwe, Qatar, the UAE, Oman, and also in the UK. Chris is a graduate of the Doncaster College of Minerals and Mining, and in addition, he studies materials technology at the University of Leeds. Chris's new role sees him as the lead and support lecturer for a wide range of the centre's modules, in particular in the fields of mineral extractives, asphalt and pavements, concrete, cement and clay. And Chris joined us on the 1st of September. Say hello to William Taylor. Bill, as he prefers to be called. Again, Bill's wide, varied and in-depth experience of the international mineral product sector is also impressive. 40 years, UK, New Zealand and Australia in both underground and surface mining extraction. Until recently, Bill was actually employed as a geography teacher. Prior to his role, he's worked as an underground mine manager, a mines and quarries inspector, a works manager, and Bill is a fellow of the Institute of Quarrying. He holds an MSc in geomorphology, and he already holds a professional graduate diploma in education. Similarly to Chris, Bill's new role sees him as the lead and support lecturer for a variety of the centre's modules. And Chris also commenced employment on the 1st of September. To prove that we're doing our bit to try and change the profile of the mineral products and quarrying sector, our next new member of staff is Dr. Helen Bailey. During the last academic year, Helen was one of the centre's associate lecturers, a job that she performed extremely well. Previously, Helen has been the technical development manager of TRL, and in addition, was a senior project manager at Gaia Environmental Technology and a research manager with Aggregate Industries. In particular, Helen brings an excellent research track record with publications as recent as February 2014. Her PhD is from the University of East London, and her first-class BEng is from the University of Leeds. Helen's new role sees her as the lead lecturer for a number of the centre's asphalt and pavement programmes. And as I've said, a research track record can only add value to the centre. Last but by no means least, particularly for you quarrying guys in the room, is our new programmes leader for extractives technology. The reason that Rob has come last is because he doesn't actually commence employment with us until the 1st of December. He's currently the head of Estates for Idstock Building Products. Rob has been a partner and director of Geoplan Consultancy, Operations Services Director for Hanson Building, Landfill Manager and Senior Geologist at Hanson Aggregates. Rob has a PhD from the University of Wales and a BSc from the University of Liverpool. Rob's new role will see him as the academic lead for all the centre's mineral extractives related programmes, so programmes like our honours degree, our foundation degree and our diplomas. Rob also brings a considerable amount of research experience that again should allow him to contribute to the centre. So what can I say? I'll admit we're not the best looking bunch, with the exception of Helen clearly. But clearly it's not about looks. What we've tried to do is put together a team that is going to enhance the centre and improve its offer. Because at the end of the day, we're in this together. This is a partnership. So moving on then, what I'd like to do very briefly now is for those of you that have not come across me before, just explain a little bit about what the centre actually does and also give you an update on what we've done in the last 12 months. So just in case anybody isn't aware, higher education generally means levels 4 to level 8. So if you think that the top of the tree, level 8, is a doctorate, those of you that have perhaps done masters, level 7, the traditional bachelor honours degree at level 6, foundation degree at levels 4 and 5, and also our diploma, and then certificates at level 4. To give you an idea, this, in a nutshell, is the centre's current offer. So at this moment in time, at the top of the shop, we have a 2-year honours degree, a level 6 programme. We offer a range of foundation degrees. I'm sure that there will be people out in the audience that will have heard the term DAPS before. In fact, it's a term that is still in ears and used on a regular basis today. The 2/3-year foundation degrees are a replacement and an enhancement on the DAPS programmes. So not only can you undertake the programme in traditional quarrying market or the asphalt market, but we now truly offer you a one-stop shop. We offer you the ability to become to study an FD in concrete or in cement technology or in clay technology, obviously manufacture of bricks. And we also offer 1-year study programmes covering the same area, our diplomas, and I'll explain a little bit more about that later on. Higher apprenticeships. Yep, I'll say again, higher apprenticeships. Believe it or not, contrary to what some of the panel members might have told you today, we can actually get young people into the industry. In fact, on the books at this minute in time, we have approximately 60 18 to 21-year-olds coming through into the industry, and I'll talk about those people a little later. Very, very briefly then, to give you an idea, if there's anybody out there who is interested in our honours degree, the honours degree starts in January. So if you're out there, you want to specialise, do an honours degree in minerals management, or any of your workforce, then please come and speak to us. We have a stand at the back. We'll be here all day tomorrow, and we'll give you further information on the honours degree. The thing to bear in mind is the honours degree is more of a management degree. It's flavoured by the one module you can see at the top, the Advanced Extractives module, but other than that, they're the traditional modules you would expect from a manager and from somebody who's going to be a leader. This module you'll see here is a work-based project module. So the idea here is to give something back to the employer. The opportunity that people you put onto this programme can actually undertake a problem within your work environment and relate it to this degree. So our standard offer, the 2 or 3 part-time foundation degree. I'm not going to go into a great deal of detail on this. We have information on it over on the back stand, but basically everything you can see up there that is a grey module is common to any pathway. So no matter whether you are following a mineral extractives route or whether you're following an asphalt route or a cement route, everybody studies the grey modules. So it covers simple things like an introduction to the industry, engineering, mathematics, business management. The yellow modules are pathway modules. And the pathway modules are decided upon depending on the pathway that you're actually following. So to give you an idea, obviously at the top for the Institute of Quarrying Conference, mineral extractives pathway, we cover mineral extraction and transportation, minerals management and processing, and blasting operations. But similarly, to give you a flavour, we also offer a whole series of pathway modules over asphalt and pavements, concrete, cement and clay. And the important thing is to understand the way that we deliver these programmes hasn't changed. All modules are still delivered by blended e-learning, continuous assessment with some examinations, supported by face-to-face. So again, you know, your workforce can stay in the workforce. They don't need to spend a long length of time out of the workforce studying with us. In the main, it is studied from your place of work and from home. Okay, I said I would mention our 1-year diploma programmes. Very simply, all we do is take out the pathway modules from our foundation degree and we package them into a 1-year intensive programme. They're aimed at a slightly different audience. So if you have graduates coming into your business, then this is the ideal programme. Basically, obviously, graduates will have already attained a qualification, but how do they learn the basics of the industry? Well, that's what these qualifications are here for. They're also open to consultants and suppliers to the industry who need to understand a little bit more about the business. And also, you know, if some of you guys out there have got bags of experience and want a qualification but don't particularly want to commit to 3 years, then these are the qualifications for you. You'll see that they're built with standard 3 modules, or in the extractives case, 2 modules, because one of them is a double module, with the option of bolting on extra modules, business management for everything, and then a selection of modules depending on what the workplace requires. So I did say I would mention the higher apprenticeship programme. Clearly, listening to the panel, both the construction industry and the mineral products industry seem to have similar problems in terms of enthusing young people to come into our industry. I was a little bit upset to hear that one of the members in the audience said, well, you know, 12 years ago we were talking about this, and I have to admit that when I first came into the industry from the coal industry, we were talking about it then. I think to try and put all the problems down to technology and computers is incorrect. I think if we honestly think that the reason we can't get people into our industry is because young people only want to sit in front of computer screens, I'm afraid we're deluding ourselves. That is part of the problem, but certainly not the root of the problem. The root of the problem, in my humble opinion, is that we do not do anything or enough to sell ourselves. We don't do enough to sell our industry. If I'm honest with you, up until 2 years ago, I had very much the same opinion as the people on this panel. I thought, the next generation of people, all they want to do is work in a call centre, all they want to do is sit in front of a tablet and work on a screen all day. And having worked with these 60 young people over the last 3 years, how wrong could I be? Because lots of young people out there want to work outside. They want to work in our industry. The problem is they don't know anything about our industry because we don't tell anybody anything about our industry. And there's only the people in the room, there's only us going to do it. It's no good handing this over to somebody else. The only people that can raise the profile of the mineral products industry and the construction products industry, because with the greatest of respect, whatever we've said today about the construction industry is nice, but it doesn't exist without our industry. It's a fact. Without our industry, there are no houses. Mr. Barrett isn't busy, and nobody else is busy. Okay? But we've got to get out there, and we've got to start doing it. We've got 60 young people. Several of the companies in the industry have stepped up to the plate. The pilot was with Hansen since then. The likes of Tarmac, the likes of Aggregate Industries have picked up the baton, and they've got a number of these people into the industry. And believe me, if you come and sit in a room with these young people, they will change your opinion. Because they challenge you like nothing you have ever seen. They're like sponges. I literally cannot get out of the classroom when I'm in with them because they soak up every bit of information. And these people are going to be the future of our industry. Because if they're not, there isn't going to be an industry. Because it's fine to have talked about everything we've talked about today, but if we don't start getting not just young people, but a whole section of people into our industry, there isn't going to be an industry. And I have to say, I don't think it's children. I think, to be fair, we've got issues with parents. We need to get out there and change their aspirations and really get into people's psyche. Because there's a reason why people think that Mr. Barrett, who was up here, apologies, I couldn't remember his name, Oliver. Well, there's a reason why people think Oliver, when he's at a function and he takes cities from Barrett's, why they think he's a bricklayer. There's a reason for that. Because that is the way people perceive the construction industry. And there's a reason when, you know, when one of us at a function and we say we work in a quarry and they go, whew, that must be a tough job, you know. Using an hammer and hitting bits of rock and you're laughing, but this is what the general public think of our industry. It's only when they get into our sites and they see what we do that their eyes open. You know, there's a reason children want to be on X Factor. It's in front of them week after week after week. It's been drilled into them. There's reasons why they want to do these things. We all know that our industry is a fantastic career choice, but we haven't got to convince anybody in the room because we're already convinced. Okay? So it's certainly a challenge. I'm not sure how we're going to do it, but this is certainly part of doing it, this higher apprenticeship. Just to give you a very brief coverage of the higher apprenticeship, again, it's offered over five pathways, again, depending on what part of the industry you're from. It's very similar in terms of the industry-specific content, but it does have some added attractions, modules like personal learning and thinking skills. I know what you're thinking. Good God, personal learning and thinking skills. When did we ever think we'd see something like that in our industry? But it's an important part for young people coming into the industry. First line supervisory management and work-based study. Very briefly, we also have certificate programmes, as I mentioned, and we have a diagram here representing our concrete programme, introduction to concrete, properties of concrete, and production use of concrete. In summary then, we offer partnership programmes tailored to industry needs, delivered now by a qualified, experienced and dedicated team. We offer a BSc, a Minerals Management Honours degree, designed specifically with the managers of UK and international mineral operations in mind. We offer a range of foundation degrees, replacement for the DAPS programmes. We offer intensive one-year diplomas. In case you haven't heard me, we offer higher apprenticeships. If you need any more information on higher apprenticeships, as I said, our stand will be over there tomorrow. Please come and talk to us about it. And we offer a range of short courses and individual modules. So what next then? My colleague, Dr. Tony Stock, raised a question earlier on about research in the industry. And this is certainly part of our challenge, because we're at the stage now where we genuinely need feedback. We are a partner organisation with the institutes. We try to deliver what we think the industry needs. So we need to hear from you. We need to know what you want us to do, what additional things that you want us to do. We have some ideas up there. So the possible expansion of our Minerals Management Honours degree, perhaps roll it out covering asphalt or concrete or other areas. We have the option to perhaps offer short courses in relation to CPD. We have the option, if there's a desire, to raise the profile of the industry further and offer master's degrees and doctorates. Okay? But we need to be led at this stage. We need to know what it is that you want. Okay, before we move on to the most important part of the day, as far as I'm concerned, but then I'm biased, I'd just like to say that the minerals industry, as far as I'm concerned, it really is vital to the economy. It's vital to our way of life. We all know this. Minerals are essential. They represent the largest material flow in the economy. We shouldn't take them for granted. So put simply, the economy couldn't function without minerals, and human life certainly couldn't be sustained at the level that it is. As far as I'm concerned, the message is clear. Minerals underpin everything in the UK economy. And what has that got to do with the Centre for Mineral Products? Well, the Centre for Mineral Products provides the majority of skills and young people coming in to sustain our industry in the long term. Very shortly, there are going to be a number of our students coming up here to achieve and be given their awards. Please don't spare your applause. Please don't spare your cheers. These people have worked extremely, extremely hard under some challenging conditions. The number of these students coming up already have operational roles. They no doubt have families to manage as well, and yet they have managed to achieve to an extremely high level. So please raise the roof for them. Many thanks for your time, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for listening to me. I'm not going to take any questions, clearly, because it's far more important that we get our students up here. I'll hand you back to Anthony. Thank you.
Surprise, he's handed you back to Phil instead. How about that? Mark, thanks very much for that thorough rendition of the programmes at Derby. Just before I get into the awards section, I'm going to repeat to you the words I've used to my colleagues back at the ranch when I saw Mark's new team come on board. With all due respect to everything that's gone before, I think this is a game changer for the University of Derby. Absolute pleasure and an absolute delight to have such talented new guys and girls coming on board at the team there with the university, and we're very, very much looking forward to working with you well into the future. Thank you. Well, welcome to the part of the evening where we get to celebrate all that is intelligent about quarrying. The Institute has a long and proud tradition of awarding prizes and honours to celebrate success within our industry. And I'd like just now to welcome to the stage again somebody that I promised his job would be all about baby kissing and opening supermarkets and all about the celebrity of the role. So big hand, please, to help me give out the awards this evening to our president, Mr. Anthony Morgan. Anthony, you get to stand there and look pretty and smile for the camera. That's your job. My job is to keep the sound man on his toes as I start to announce the winners of the prizes. We begin with awarding prizes to the rising stars of our industry, to the men and women who are studying on the extractive programmes that Mark outlined at the University of Derby, our hosts for this evening. The prizes that we give, in fact, are all supported by trust funds that originally were donated to the Institute years and years ago for the purposes of recognising excellence and encouraging students to perform well and motivating them in their studies. Many of the companies that set up these trust funds are no longer with us, so for those of you that have been around a long time, you'll perhaps enjoy this trip down memory lane as I try and trip over the names of the awards. However, I'd like to begin with a name that is very much here in the present. I think Debbie is poised to help with... Debbie, you're providing the glamour alongside Anthony to help give out the certificates. I'd like to begin with... Thank you, Sarah. I should have done that, shouldn't I, really? There we are. I'd like to begin with the Longcliff Calcium Carbonates Awards. These are given in recognition in excellence for each year of the study, on the foundation degrees at the University of Derby. And so, poised for slight embarrassment when I read out a name and the person doesn't come up on the stage, the runner-up for excellence in the first year of the foundation degrees of Tarmac is Edward Watts. And winner of the award for excellence in the first year of the foundation degrees, also from Tarmac, Robert Symes. Robert. On to the second year of the programmes, the foundation degree, again staying with the Longcliff Calcium Carbonates Awards. Runner-up for excellence in the second year of CEMEX is Amy Cooper. And winner of the award for excellence in the second year of the foundation degree, again of Tarmac, is Robert Kelly. Robert. Well done, folks. Here's your first blast from the past, a trip down memory lane as we celebrate the Goodwin Barsby Award. This is given for the best students in the Construction Materials Technology module, and runner-up this year is of Hanson James Angel. James, did I get your name right? Is it Angel? Anger? Angel, it is. Thanks very much indeed. And I know that the winner of the Goodwin Barsby Award for Construction Materials Technology, who couldn't be with us, again of Tarmac, is Heather Bennett. Should we give Heather a round of applause in her absence? The Rexnord Award is given for the best students in blasting technology. And runner-up for this year is, of Aggregate Industries, Chris Withers. And winner of the Rexnord Award for Blasting, clearly a person to know, of Aggregate Industries, is Anthony Parkinson. Is Anthony here? Now on to the Ransoms Rapier Award. Are you staying with me on these names? I'm just about hopefully getting the pronunciation right. The Ransoms Rapier Award, given for the best students in engineering taken from the second and third year marks. I know that the runner-up this year can't be with us, of Darrington Quarries, that's Glyn Guthrie. Round of applause for Glyn. And the winner of the Ransoms Rapier Award for engineering in its second time on stage for, of Hanson, James Angel. James. Well done, James. Now, the Tilcon Award, another ring of the bell there. The Tilcon Award is given for business management, and to receive the prize for runner-up this year, it's back onto the stage for Anthony Parkinson of Aggregate Industries. And for top marks in business management and the winner of the Tilcon Award, please welcome to the stage of Aggregate Industries, Charlie West. Well done, Charlie. And on to the Peter Preston Award. This recognises the best marks from the technology elements of the two modules. Our 2016 runner-up of Huntsman's Quarries Breeden is Julian Veal. Julian. And in fact, the winner of the Peter Preston Award for Technology, and I'm sure he's out celebrating because he can't be with us, it would have been second time on stage for Glyn Guthrie of Darrington Quarries. So for the record, Glyn, congratulations. Now, health, safety, environmental issues, as we've heard and as we know all too well, are key features of the programmes running at the University of Derby. The Reginald W. Coles Prize is given for excellence in health, safety, and environmental areas. Runner-up for this year of Aggregate Industries is Gemma Moore. Hello, Gemma. And winner of the Reginald W. Coles Prize for Excellence in Health, Safety and the Environment is, of Huntsman's Quarries, Julian Veal. And so, to conclude this section of the awards, we're on to the final award for the University of Derby programmes. This is the Leonard Clugston Prize, which is awarded for the student who gets the highest average mark across all of the modules in the second and third years. And the 2015 winner of the Leonard Clugston Prize, and for the third time on stage this evening from Huntsman's Quarries Breeden, it's Julian Veal. Well then, Julian. Congratulations, one and all. You guys are the heroes of our industry and the rising stars, so many, many congratulations indeed. And you can probably tell by the enthusiasm of the crowd just how proud you should be of achieving those awards. We're now on to an institute award called the President's Branch Trophy, which was originally donated by Graham Shove, who was president of the institute from 1996 to 1997. And each year, the President's Branch Trophy is awarded to the branch that is judged to have run the most educational and innovative branch program for the year. And this year, I can tell you, the competition was very stiff indeed. There was some excellent, excellent work being done out there amongst our branches, carried out by our tireless branch committee members, all of whom are volunteers within the institute. And I know the judges were very, very hard pushed indeed to determine a winner. So first of all, on their recommendation, I'd like to give a special commendation to the West of England branch for its work at the Earth Science Centre at Moon Hills Quarry in the Mendips. Congratulations to the West of England branch. I really should pay attention to the slides, Sarah. Thanks for keeping me on my toes. That's great. But the winner of the 2015 President's Branch Trophy for running an inspiring series of events aimed at engaging the individual member is the North of England branch. And here to receive the trophy on behalf of the North of England branch is Joe Banner. Joe. Many congratulations, Joe, and to the North of England branch. Please take our best wishes back up to the North of England for us. I can see Sarah hovering, and I'm going to press the button, Sarah, because we're on now to welcome on board a new member to the Institute's Corporate Professional Competence Scheme. Since 2009, the Institute's CPC scheme has aimed at encouraging operating companies in particular, as well as suppliers and contractors, to commit to a series of obligations relating to safety, health and environmental objectives. Specifically, those obligations focus upon the professional competence of their staff, ensuring that all managers and supervisors hold relevant competency-based qualifications and are signed up to an auditable programme of CPD. And it's my great pleasure to invite to the stage to, to sign this certificate with our President, Anthony Morgan, John Dye and Daniel Brunt to receive the CPC Scheme Certificate for MDB Engineering. Guys, welcome on board. MDB Engineering. Thanks very much. Last prize-giving session of the evening, then you can get back to your drinks, sponsored by the University of Derby. We want to cost you guys some money this evening by keeping the drinks flowing. In 2015, we launched a new IQ photo competition that was open to all of our current members and running under the theme Quarries Rock. Can you see what we did there? The focus behind the competition was to provide a glimpse into the vast diversity of quarry sites, demonstrating how wildlife lives and thrives in harmony with the operations being undertaken. Our 12 finalists, featuring in our new 2016 calendar, were selected from a number of entries who best demonstrated the range of factors, including composition, technical ability, originality, and interpretation of the brief, and in fact, the overall appeal of the photographs. And I can tell you, having looked at the 50-odd photographs that were on the wall in the small meeting room in our office, that there were really some fantastic entries and a great response to what was in fact our first photo competition. So a warm welcome is given to our two joint first prize winners, and you must, I don't know whether you'll get a chance to take a look while they're on the stage, you must take a look at these photographs. And these stood out from our other 10 finalists, to both the judges and our members who voted in the competition. So please give a warm welcome to the stage to two people, Amy Louise Cooper of Cemex, brackets frog, and Steve Burton, White Building Materials, brackets owl.
Yeah.
Well done, folks. Absolutely stunning photographs. And do try and get hold of one of those calendars. Absolutely stunning photos all year round. So, ladies and gentlemen, that actually concludes our awards ceremony. Congratulations to everyone that's been under the stage to receive one of our awards, our prizes, our accolades. Please enjoy the rest of the evening. Make the University of Derby our hosts pay for the rest of the drinks. And please join us here back in the morning for the second day of Intelligent Quarrying. Thanks very much and good evening.